Moods may also have an effect on how information is processed, by influencing the extent to which judges rely on pre-existing, internal information, or focus on new, external information. Positive moods promote more holistic and top-down processing style, while negative moods recruit more stimulus-driven and bottom-up processing. The problem begins with the alphabet itself. Building a spelling system for English using letters that come from Latin, despite the two languages not sharing exactly the same set of sounds, is like building the playroom using an IKEA office set. Such cross-protection is usually seen between two animals. But Gore studies the same sort of mutualism in microbes. He and his team demonstrated the first experimental example of that cross-protective relationship in drug-resistant microbes, using two strains of antibiotic-resistant modern buildings have to achieve certain performance requirements, at least to satisfy those of building codes, to provide a safe, healthy, and comfortable environment. However, these conditioned environments demand resources in energy and materials, which are both limited in supply, to build and operate. The numbers on U.S. student debt, after all, are truly staggering. The average 2015 U.S. university graduate who took out loans to help pay for tuition enters the workforce with $35,000 in student debt. In the U.S., total student debt exceeds $1.15 trillion, dwarfing, for instance, the nation's credit card debt. The Office of Personnel Management was the target of the attack, but data from nearly every government agency was stolen. U.S. investigators say they believe Chinese hackers were behind the breach. Global warming is defined as an increase in the average temperature of the Earth's atmosphere. This trend began in the middle of the 20th century and is one of the major environmental concerns of scientists and governmental officials worldwide. As far as politics go, the responses are just as varied. Mitigation is common and calls for a reduction of emissions and less reliance on fossil fuels. Coal-burning power plants are now replaced with hydraulic power plants, and electrical cars are replacing some gasoline-efficient cars. Many people, however, feel that this is not enough. The speaker is a marine biologist who became interested in the Strandlotters, an ancient people who lived on the coastline, because of their connection to the sea. Their way of life intrigued him. As a child, he had spent a lot of time by the sea, exploring and collecting things, so he began to study them, and discovered some interesting information about their way of life. Market research is a vital part of the planning of any business. However experienced you or your staff may be in a particular field, if you are thinking of introducing the service to a new area, it is important to find out what the local population thinks about it first. The English Revolution has been interpreted in several ways by historians, as a fight between the aristocratic cavaliers, who were open to life, and the serious Puritans, as a battle for power between Parliament and the monarchy over the rights of Englishmen that had been going on for centuries. Thompson recognized and exploited all the ingredients of a successful amusement ride, writes Judith A. Adams in The American Amusement Park Industry. His coasters combined an appearance of danger with actual safety, thrilled riders with exhilarating speed, and allowed the public to intimately experience the industrial revolutions. Botanic gardens are scientific and cultural institutions established to collect, study, exchange and display plants for research and for the education and enjoyment of the public. There are major botanic gardens in each capital city. Zoological parks and aquariums are primarily engaged in the breeding. The curriculum enhances the general management program with health-related courses, Dr. Chalmat says. Required courses include healthcare in the 21st century and the economics and strategy of health sector management. Students may also take electives such as medical device commercialization. The best comparison is likely a magnetar, a young neutron star with a powerful magnetic field, the researcher said. Magnetars also produce bright X-ray flares. While magnetars are thought to be young stars, the two flaring objects in this study reside near elliptical galaxies, which contain older stars. So the objects are likely too old to be magnetars, the researcher said. Researchers gathered 160 uncaffeinated adults, people who consumed less than 500 milligrams of caffeine a week. These detox subjects looked at pictures of various objects, then took either a placebo or a pill containing 200 milligrams of caffeine. That's roughly the amount you'd get from 2 cups of coffee. Many papers you write in college will require you to include quotes from one or more sources. Even if you don't have to do it, integrating a few quotes into your writing can add life and persuasiveness to your arguments. The key is to use quotes to support a point you're trying to make rather than just include them to fill space. Some people object that in order for the eye to modify and still remain a useful instrument to its owner, many changes would have had to take place simultaneously. However, it is not necessary to suppose this if the modifications were extremely slight and gradual. As a historian, if you really want to understand the sensibilities of those who lived in the past, you must be like a novelist and get into the skins of your characters and think and feel as they do. You are asked to imagine what it's like to be a peasant in medieval times, asking the sort of questions a peasant might ask. It is difficult to tell whether the speaker approves of Hemingway's lifestyle or not. He was famously macho and spent a lot of time hunting wild animals, going to wars and getting into fights. All these things got into his books, and the speaker thinks that this is not necessarily a good thing as it means that too many people prefer to read about his life than read his books.